Hello and welcome back. Many people have asked this question, how we can transfer data from a user form to different Excel worksheets in a workbook. Let me just minimize this here. So a user has three worksheets like customer details, product details, and shipment details. In the Visual Basic for Applications window, he has created a user form, something like this, with the invoice details as the header. This is a label. Then he has created the invoice number, invoice date, and using the multi-page item from the toolbox controls here, he has created the details for customer, product, shipment. Now, when he clicks on this transfer button, he wishes that each of this data from the customer page, product page, and the shipment page goes to the respective Excel worksheet. For example, the customer details should come here, the product details should come here, and so on. Okay, now to ensure that he knows which details belong to which customer, and also so that he can maintain an inventory, he always uses the invoice number and the invoice date with the other details. Okay, so we'll go to the Visual Basic area, and we know how to create a user form like this. We have done this many times, and I will provide the links to a multi-page user form. Okay, so we need to code now the transfer data button. Okay, so if I double click on this, and now between these two lines of code, we are going to write our VBA code, which will transfer the data from the different text boxes, combo boxes, and the multi-pages to our relevant Excel worksheets. Okay, we'll start by defining the variables that we will need for the transfer when the user clicks on the transfer data button. So dim lrcd. Now this stands for last row customer details as long. Similarly, last row product details as long. And finally, last row shipment, we'll just write S as long. Now, once we click on the transfer button, the first thing that we should know, if we transfer that data to, let's say, customer details, we should know how many rows have already been used on that worksheet, right? So we will start with the last row, customer details, that we assign the value sheets. Now in this, we do not write sheet 1, but we write our sheet name or worksheet name, which is customer details. And you have to write it exactly as you have written it on your worksheet. Dot range. And we start at column A. And then we count the rows, and rows dot count. You will see that this is pretty easy to do. Okay. So dot end in parentheses or brackets, Excel up dot row. In this manner, we find the last row in the customer details which have been used. Now, the data that will be entered in the next row, isn't it? The last row we find, let's say the first two rows are used. So we are going to enter the data in the third row. So I'm going to write the code for how to transfer, for example, this data, invoice number, to the customer details. Okay. So we'll write sheets. Customer details. Dot cells. Now here we use the cells property and we'll write last row CD customer details plus 1. That is where our data is going to go row wise. And the invoice number is going to go into column A. Alright. So that value that will come into this row and the column A, we will get from our text box 1 dot text. Alright. In a similar fashion, I'm going to get the data from the invoice date, and then I'm also going to get in this customer details the customer name and the customer address. That will happen in a code that will look just like this. So I'm going to write that code quickly and you can then have a look at it. Okay. If you now look at the second line of code, it gets the data into the B column from the text box 2, which is the invoice date. Similarly, this is the customer name, customer address, and finally, just to show you an example, when the address comes in, we want to fit the data into the column. Okay. All right. Now, in a similar fashion, I'm going to define how to get the data into the product details and into the shipment details worksheets. And you will see it's just like the one that is defined here. So we define here the last row product details, just like we did in the customer details. It's the same code, except that we use here product details, and you see here there is an error. So I'm going to change this. So this should be product details, okay? And here it should be the shipment details. So that can happen sometimes when you copy paste to make the work faster. Okay. So once the last row use has been determined, then you take the invoice, that is the text box 1 here. It will go to the row and column here, then the invoice date, and then we have the details like the description from text box 5, and we have the unit price, and then we have the quantity here, and finally we calculate the amount here itself, you see. And how do we do the calculation? We take the value, val takes the value from text box 6 and the value from text box 7, multiplies them, you see here, and gives us the amount. Why do we need to do this? Well, when you enter data into a text box, it is text. So if you had here, let's say 1750 and you had 10 here, it would just make it 1760, something like that. Okay, they just concatenate that. Whereas when you convert that into a val, you will get the correct value. Okay. Now this code will of course be available to you on the website. So nothing to worry. Similarly, we have the last row in the shipment details. Then we take the shipment mode. Okay. And then here, let me just show you the object and shipment. So we have the transport mode and the destination. Okay. Now, if you notice here, in the shipment details, we are using a combo box. Okay. Because here we would like to have, for example, in the transport mode, we would like to say by air or by land. Okay. Let me show you that. You can see here transport mode. And these are the options here. I'll show you also how I've defined that. I've defined that using an array, and that happens when the form loads, that means when the form initializes. Okay, so I'm going to double click on the form now because our code for the transfer data is complete. Okay, let me double click on the form, and if you see here, instead of click, I'm going to take initialize. There it is. So the procedure will be initialized. And here, the first thing I'm going to do is, I want that the cursor goes to the invoice number, because that is the first thing I want to fill. So I will say text box 1 dot set focus. Okay. Then the invoice date, I need not fill up every time. I can assign it a value of the date on which I'm working. Okay. So text, and that will be assigned the value date. That means today's date. And the combo box 1 dot list, we will assign an array value. So we will say, for example, by air or by land. This is a great way of defining the values that you want in your combo box. So if you wanted more, you would separate them by commas and have as many as you like. For example, if you wanted months, you would write here January, February, March, April, up to December. Okay. So, once we have this code, we can now try it out. Okay. You also know how to populate combo boxes. You see here, combo box 1. So, I'm using combo box 1 here. We know how to populate combo boxes by using the row source. That means we write the values in a worksheet, and then either using the name range or just taking those values in the rows, we can assign it in the properties box of the combo box. Okay. So now let me go to view object and let's run this. Okay. So I'll just bring this down here and we click on the run button. And there you see, we have the invoice number, so let me just take it to the side. So the invoice number will come here. It will of course depend on what you're adding here. So let's say we have invoice 1. Generally it's a procedure. You can't have invoices like 1, 2, 3, 5, because law requirements are different in different countries, but generally you're supposed to have the invoices 1, 2, 3, 4, and if you cancel some, you can do that and issue a new invoice. But your number 4 has to be shown as cancelled. Okay, so you see here the cursor came here first. I put 1, the date has come here, so I'm going to go to customer and I'm going to write a customer name, let's say Tom Jones. Okay, address, let's say I write some fictitious address, 123. I'm writing an Indian address because that's what I'm familiar with. Okay, so let's say opposite temple. And let's say New Delhi, and I'll write a pin code. Okay, so then I go to product and I write here product description, for example, Intel CPU i7, unit price, let's say I write 7900 rupees. Okay, when you have it in dollars, you write it differently. So quantity is 10, I'm writing 10 so that we can immediately see whether our calculations of the amount are correct. Okay, so shipment, so I go here and transport mode, if I click here I can say by air. Okay, and destination is where the person lives, so let's say Delhi, that's where he gave his address, and I click on transfer data. Okay, and there you see the data has been transferred. Let me just close this. So let's have a look at our worksheets. So let's go to the customer details first. So we have here invoice number 1, today's date, the customer name, and you see here there is an auto fit of the address as I had done in the code. You remember that? Then the product details, I have again the invoice number and the invoice date. Then I have the product description. This also you can auto fit if you want. The unit price, quantity, and you see her amount has been automatically calculated. Let's go to the shipment details. So invoice number, invoice date, by air, and Delhi. Now you can see that this is a very powerful way of working. You could have more details, for example, here in the product, and you could do an inventory management also. And if you wanted to create a database of your customers, you had a database here. Alright, I hope you found this useful. Thanks for watching.